Hey everybody, this is Big Jim W, and today I'm going to show you how to roll your own perfect cigarette. I did kind of fall off the wagon. I know, I suck. I was on the electronic cigarette for a while, and I did quit smoking, but, I fell off because of a lot of stress that went on in my life. So I did start smoking back, and I am going to go back on the electronic cigarette because that works. It really does. But for the meantime, I'm kind of stuck in this purgatory here. Of cigarette smoking, and when I bought my first pack of cigarettes, I was really appalled at these Pall Malls. I mean, they were like almost $6.50 a pack. I can't afford that anymore. I mean, I'm done with buying this kind of crap. If I don't want to pay Obama any more than he needs to get, as far as his his little socialist grand scheme of things. But that's why I roll my own cigarettes. You see, they come out pretty good, and they actually taste pretty much like a commercially grade cigarette, and tobacco don't fall out. There's many options online right now as to what you can use to roll your own cigarettes. Some people do it the old-fashioned way, like Clint Eastwood and James Dean, some cowboy movie. But we're in the 20th century or the 21st century right now, so we don't need to do that. One of the options that you have is one of these electric machines. It's called, it's an auger type of machine. It works on the principle of a spring inside, as you can see. That spring supposedly pushes the tobacco through the tube and ejects the tube out here. Now, one of the big problems with these type of machines is it grinds the tobacco. It grinds it to almost a powder. Don't smoke a cigarette made from one of these machines anywhere unless you have a big ashtray in front of you, because the cherry, otherwise known as the head or the cherry, the fire end of the cigarette is going to fall off. It's going to fall off in your lap, and you're going to burn your crotch, maybe your balls. These things are junk. They're made from fucking China. Sure, I can roll a pack of cigarettes in about 5 minutes with this thing. You know what this does right now? It's nothing more than a paperweight. Go with the American-made stuff, okay? Tops makes a couple of good cigarette machines. This is actually a hand roller that I use. They make a Top-O-Matic. I don't have one of those. If ever I get some money back into my income, I'll certainly get a Top-O-Matic. But this thing pretty much does the same thing Top-O-Matic does, but it takes a little bit more work. What you get with it is instructions. You don't have to read that shit. A tamper, which is very important, and I'll show you in a minute. An extra nozzle, just in case your primary nozzle breaks and you need to replace it. It's quite easy to replace. Okay, here's how you make a cigarette. Commercially made type of cigarette that the cherry will not fall off, will taste just like a cigarette, will handle like a cigarette, will feel like a cigarette, with the consistency all the way to the tip. Now, here's how you do it. First thing you're going to do is you need tobacco. Now you can use either this or any brand of tobacco. This just happens to be the Gambler Regular. Or if you want a little bit of spice in your life, get the Gambler Mint, which is basically like a menthol. It actually is menthol. One thing about these pipe tobaccos, they're really not pipe tobacco in the pure sense of the word. If you try to smoke this shit in a pipe, it's going to suck. The tobacco companies answered Obama's little Highway Act bullshit by cutting cigarette tobacco just a little bit thicker and selling it as pipe tobacco, which is not subjected to Obama's tax. Obama, you can suck my ass. Okay, so how do you make a tax-free cigarette that Obama doesn't get a dime on, which is quite easy? Get some tubes. These tubes, you get about 200 in a box. They're about $2-3, depending on what kind of quality you get. The tubes look like this. They're basically a cigarette tube with the filter. This one here is a menthol one. The menthol is infused in the filter. It's empty. Just like Obama's head. Okay, so what do I do next? I want to make this one kind of like a Newport, So, if I wanted a cool type of cigarette, cool tasting cigarette, which is like cool, K-O-L's, I use the mint stuff, that is like sucking on a candy cane. But I'm going to use the regular flavored tobacco. and what just happened to you. Okay, folks, be right back. One second. Alright, folks, we're back. Something happened here. I must have bumped the lens or something. Hello, folks. Okay, anyway, back to what I was saying. I'm going to make the Newport type, where I'm going to use a regular full-flavored tobacco and a menthol tube. Alright, here's how you make it. Let's not hit the lens again, Jim. Okay, I like to grab just enough tobacco out of here, just so I know it might make a good cigarette. That looks good. Check the stems, because in these cans you do get some stems once in a while. Everything looks good here. I mean, I can make a pack of cigarettes with this thing in about maybe 15 minutes. It takes me only about 5 minutes with that auger thing, but screw that. If you want a good quality cigarette, you work on it. I like to fill the ends a little bit here, just to make sure we get enough here. And then use the rest to fill the middle. Like that. Okay. Make sure it's all spread out nice and good. Okay, now everything's spread out nice and good. You take your tamper. This is the tampon thing, I like to call it. You know, you gotta tamp it down good. See, this is how you make it. You don't have to push down really hard, just enough to get it in here. I mean, you know, you gotta eyeball it at first when you first start making cigarettes. See? This could use just a tad bit more on the side, so maybe I'll just take a little bit here and just put it right there, just to kind of make it nice, okay, because that's where the filter is going to be filled. You know, you don't want a loose filter, you know. I mean, I can make one pretty a lot faster than this. I'm just doing it slow here to show you guys, but all right, all nice and tamped down. See, you know, things like get some junk out of there. See how it's nice and tamped in there? Okay, so next thing you gotta do, this aside, take your tube. Okay, now at the end of this thing, you should have a nozzle. This thing is a little, get some of that junk out of there. It's a lot of tobacco in there. There we go. It's got a nozzle at the end. Okay, just put the tube on the nozzle. You gotta be very careful with these because, you know, you don't have much tolerance or clearance when it comes to putting the tube on. Then you just close it. It's got its own little tamper here to keep all the tobacco in place. Lock it in place. Slide it. Perfect. And the nice thing about this thing is, unlike the auger type of crap that China sells, is the cherry doesn't fall off the cigarette when you smoke it. It's very consistent from filter to tip. It looks pretty much exactly like a cigarette that you would see in a $7 pack of cigarettes. Okay, maybe let's make another one. I got a few minutes left. Hey, let's make another one. Let's do another one. We can do it. Alright, just pack it in here. Make sure that everything is nice and even. Yeah, it's a little messy, but you know what? It's easy to clean up. Don't worry about it. Make sure everything's nice and even. Take your tamper, like this, and just kind of scrunch it in there. Make sure that it's nice and packed. You don't have to do it very hard, just, you know, just nice and packed. Okay? Then you take another tube, put it on the end here, wipe it down, and there you go. Another one. Now I am going to go on the electronic cigarettes. I'm going to go back on the electronic cigarettes when I get the chance. Seriously, I mean, smoking is not good for you, regardless of whether or not it's rolling your own or buying the stuff that you get, manufactured with all the chemicals. Smoking's not good. I mean, you got to really quit smoking. If you really want to. Like, but if you want to continue to smoke, one of these machines, you know, economical, buck a pack, 10 bucks a carton, beat 70, 80 bucks a carton, doesn't it? And this only cost me, $6. Tobacco, $7.50. The tubes, $2.50. And you get a carton with that. Alright, so with that, folks, this is Jim W. giving you the tour of the Top machine. Take care. God bless. Vape strong, because I am going to be vaping strong very soon. I'm tired of smoking. I'm tired of being sick and tired. Bye.